Boomered that one. Oh, all right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of Legion Talk. And I tell you what, this whole Hogwarts Legacy thing is just getting out of control. Still to this point, it has been months and months and months, and the backlash just does not seem to want to go away. People are still losing their minds from a Twitter user called Bonicula Vampire VTuber with regards to that wizard game. So that's what they're doing. First off, they're calling it that wizard game because they're trying to other people who are playing it, which is absolute nonsense. It's a game, ladies and gentlemen. It's not hurting people unless you have like the possibility of epileptic seizures. That's about it. But let's take a look at this video. It's about 2 minutes long.
It's hard to care, but it's also potentially a little bit dangerous not to care at the moment. These people are getting completely insane. You think the rhetoric against trans kids is bad now? Oh, it's gonna get really fucking gross in the next year. Brace yourselves, it's going to get worse. I know things are scary right now. It's gonna get worse. At least we have the Harry Potter video game to fight about. People are so silly about that. Oh no, I got harassed for playing the wizard game. And it's like, yeah, shut up. Suck it up. If you honestly are playing that game and didn't expect to get a little flack from it, it means you literally have not been listening to Jewish people. You have not been listening to
Let me explain. The flack about Jewish people is apparently the goblins in the game are anti-Semitic because they've been compared to Jewish people. I haven't made that comparison. Most sane people haven't made that comparison, but the weirdos online have. The weirdos. But yeah, they're like, if you didn't expect to get hate because you haven't been paying attention to the Jewish people or trans people, no, it's the weirdos like you. You're a VTuber who sounds like a dude. You sound like an effeminate dude, but you know, teach their own.
Trans people, you have not been listening to anybody about the problems with JK fucking Rowling and the goddamn wizarding world of Harry Potter. If you honestly thought you could just play that on stream and not have somebody be like, hey, could you not? The woman actively has said out loud that she gives money that she receives as proceeds, the royalties on the games like that, she gives them directly to the same people that are pounding trans kids in Texas. So,
where are the receipts, by the way? Where are the receipts for these people hounding the trans kids, just for the record? Trans children don't exist. Okay, Mr. Silly Bears? If you're 18 years old and you decide that you want to go down that road, I am perfectly accepting of that. I'm perfectly okay with that. It is you. It is your body. Do not tell a five-year-old who just wants to maybe once in a while play with a Barbie doll. Do not tell them that they might be a girl, because it's not true.
Fuck her. And if you stream it, fuck you.
Oh, I'm going to stream it, fucker. Eat a dick. Oh, wait, you probably already have.
Oh, so I'm doing it to support the devs. The devs have been paid. Shut up. That argument doesn't make sense. Oh, it's my nostalgia. Cool. Go reread the books on your bookshelf. I also see the argument that it's like, oh, well, you know, there's no ethical concern.
You also know that there's a trans bartender in Hogsmeade, right? Seriously. I'm sure some people are probably saying it's like a troll or it's a shot over the bow because I guess look kind of like a woman but has like a deep voice. I don't know. I haven't had a chance to start playing the game yet, but I'm going to, and I'm gonna stream it. Oh, these same weirdos made a list of all the people streaming the game. So, yeah, I think it got taken down because it's wow, that's next level. But yeah, so you could go to their chat and harass them for streaming the game. Super, that's super level-headed. It's not, that's not insane at all.
Consumption under capitalism. And it's like, yes, darling, of course. I think you misunderstand how that phrase is supposed to be used. No ethical consumption under capitalism indicates that we, by necessity, must participate in the cruel machinery of capitalism in order to sustain ourselves with food and shelter and housing.
This from a VTuber who probably makes a lot of money. You know that VTubers for the longest time were some of the highest paid YouTubers there are. So I'm just saying, pot calling the kettle black. You're a capitalist socialist.
Not with video games. So if you can forego a morally, an ethically dubious purchase, by all means forego it. I entreat you. That's my soapbox, and I'll get off it now.
It sounds like a stable fucking person, right? Hold on. I want to go to this person's. Yeah, VTuber, blah, 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 Twitch TV. All right, so I'm going to have 1,700 followers on Twitter. And on Twitch, they have 1,100 followers. And I can show that to you. Hold on real quick. So they have 1,100 followers on Twitch, which means that, yeah.
Oh, I drooled a little bit. What the fuck?
I'm so glad that so there's the stability of people right there. People who are on Twitch make a good chunk of change. It's really hard to get followers on Twitch because they don't promote your content at all. And quite frankly, you can't even get partnered until you have like a certain amount of watch hours and 50 subscribers. It's lower than YouTube, 1,000 subscribers, because it's so hard to get followers on Twitch. But, you know, I guarantee they probably make, I wouldn't be surprised if they make probably $4,000 a month from 1,100. It might be more, because Twitch's numbers are much higher than YouTube. Like, I think a Twitch streamer with like 5,000 followers is comparable to somebody who's in the neighborhood of like having, I think, like 70,000 on YouTube, somewhere in that ballpark. So they're probably doing pretty darn good. Yeah, it's, I could calculate it right now, and if I, you know, I might calculate in the future, but as of right now, you make money off Twitch, and that wizard game is problematic. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, go over to silkcityhotsauce.com, use the promo code Legion, LEGION, at checkout. You get 15% off. They're a small business out of Southern Vermont, family-owned business. They have great hot sauces. They support Chrissy Mayer and Alex Stein and all that kind of stuff. And I definitely think you should check it out. Again, promo code Legion, LEGION. It's silkcityhotsauce.com. And you can get 15% off at checkout. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And I tell you what, this Hogwarts Legacy thing is just not going to go away. See you guys.